welcome to another episode of Life at Sea. Today we're looking at docking and undocking of cargo ships. This video is going to be pretty relatable to all kinds of cargo ships because, well, even though we're in 2020, all ships still use ropes and the same traditional equipment that they used to use like 50 years ago to dock and undock. So basically, in this video, I'm going to run you through docking and undocking the entire procedure. I've shot some amazing footage in the port of Ulsan. I'm also going to take you around my ship to my mooring stations where the crew actually stand and work and pass the ropes. And I'm going to show you what equipment we have there. I'm going to show you how the equipment works.
So, we all know that ships have engines. The engine's connected to this giant wheel at the back known as the propeller. And the propeller is what turns when the engine runs. That causes the ship to move forward and backwards. Now, the engine along with the steering wheel of the ship, basically together, that's the main maneuvering system for most cargo ships. Other than that, we also have certain small propellers known as thrusters.
Now, to put things into perspective, a propeller is like a really, really gigantic metal fidget spinner that rotates at high speeds when the engine turns. And so now that we know what a propeller is, you take the same propeller and you reduce the size and put it on the forward part of the ship on the left and the right hand side. These are known as thrusters. These thrusters basically enhance the movement of the ship in such a way that they help the ship move in the left and right, that is the sideways, the athwart ship direction. Basically, along with the engine and the steering wheel and the thrusters, put all of this together, and these are the internal factors that help maneuver a ship. Another way clear with the internal maneuvering factors of the ship and the maneuvering capabilities which are enhanced by all the equipment that we've talked about, let's talk about external factors. Every time a ship is entering a port, you're going to basically have these small boats known as tugboats. Every port has its own local tugboats that come alongside towards the ship. Now, if you don't know what a tugboat is a really large version of a motorboat with a large amount of muscle power. Basically, it's a motorboat high on protein that has the ability to pull and push a ship. And depending on the size of a ship, you can either have one tugboat assisting you, two tugboats, maybe even four tugboats if you're a really, really large ship. Now that you're aware of all the equipment that is required to maneuver a vessel and you know what tugboats are, let's go and check out the forward and the after stations that we have on board our ship where the crew, the officers stand by and carry out the mooring operation. And then let's look at how our ship actually docks and undocks. Let's get into it.
Your current location is the aft mooring station, which is normally manned by one deck officer and three deck ratings. You can see the duty officer signaling the ratings to pick up the ropes which are in the water while departing a port. The ropes are being picked up using these hydraulic motors, which are known as winches. Here you can see an overview of the aft station once we have departed port. Now I'm taking you forward. Welcome to the forward station. This is a larger version of the aft station. As you can see right now, the ropes are well secured. We have to keep them like that while we're out at sea. Just like the aft station, we have hydraulic motors, known as winches even on the forward station. Every mooring operation requires ship and shore personnel to work together. As you can see, the shore person lets go of the ropes once the ropes are already slack. The duty officer on the aft station and the forward station will instruct their crew to pick up the ropes using the hydraulic motors. Using the engines and the thrusters along with the tugs, the ship slowly moves out of the jetty. Now let me show you how this is done from a third person perspective. This part of the video was shot when my ship was already berthed alongside at the port of Ulsan. Remember the engines and thrusters we spoke about? Take a look. The ship that you're currently looking at is coming into the port of Ulsan, making use of her engines, her steering system, and a tugboat assisting her, keeping her in position and helping her maneuver herself. The next step is to get in line with the jetty, send out her mooring ropes, and the jetty personnel will pull the ropes in. You can see that the tugboat is actually pushing the ship in so that she can get into position. She's now sending her final set of ropes to make fast the ship and make sure she doesn't move. You've seen the docking procedure. Now let's look at undocking. At this point, you can see dual action, with the thrusters pushing from ahead and the tugboats pulling from behind. Hence, the ship moves out bodily. You probably noticed there's an anchor paid out into the water. More on that in another video. It's a different kind of mooring procedure. With the force of the tugboat, the engines, the steering, the anchor and the thrusters all put together, the ship manages to turn about its same position and then slowly moves out of the port. That was docking and undocking of cargo ships. If you enjoyed this video, hit that like button, subscribe, and stay tuned for more. See you in the next one.